we're doing a little tour, showing the new products, demoing, doing some clinics at a handful of different stores.
Really just started in early 90s, 92 in LA, and messing around with the Craig Anderton book, and then you know, a lot of the pedals back then, with the exception of, you know, maybe MXR, Boss, would fall apart. Those ones wouldn't, you know, the other brands. I had a Foxtel machine that was like a tuna can, it would just fall apart. But it sounded great, and I wanted to create some pedals that did what I needed them to do. I really started doing it for myself.
The thing that I always remember that I was most proud of is when I actually got the Aquapus analog delay to work, because I really was way over my head at the time, and it was a proud moment. Like, hey, I made it work. It's delaying. It sounds right. How did I do this?
The name.
No, I mean it's a muff style pedal, so it's just a big tone dominating thing, and lots of low end, works on bass. So, and the name. It varies. It really just varies. You know, it can be as much as someone says something like, that's a great name, write that down. And it becomes something, or, you know, something like Swole Pickle, or it's like, okay, it's this muff type thing. How do you create a name as iconic and cool as Big Muff?
Yeah. Okay.
Which took a lot of thesaurus searching. You know, other stuff like Aquapus, it was doing the delay, and the anodized shop had this really cool aqua color. So originally it was called the Aqua Octopus, which is really hard to say. Say that three times and it just becomes Aquapus.
It's all great. I mean, to me, it's just you trying to create music.
Yeah.
And however that works, it works. Honestly, I don't think there's any bad gear. There's just
bad uses.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, it's just trying to be creative and make music. You do have a tendency, oh, that's wrong. You know, there's the whole, like, you have to do things this way. And usually I tell people, though, just, you know, what's the right way to hook stuff up? I'm like, there isn't one, the one that sounds right. You know, because when you start working with artists and stuff and you really get into how they're using your gear, I'm many times stunned, like, well, that's weird. That's not right. But it works, so done. And with anybody, it's really sitting down and talking to someone, having them either play for you or give you, like, this is the sound I'm looking for, listening to tracks, using knowledge base, just go, okay, yeah, it could be this, and then start down the path.
Okay.
Yeah, there isn't a, you know, check this, it just sort of happens, you know, and it depends on the artist. Some know exactly, some like, oh, I need something like this. Oh yeah, I remember going to see Tom Petty at the Hollywood Bowl. With the binoculars looking and going, he's using the Red Llama, oh, that's so cool. It's pretty easy. Fuzzface, Crybaby, and probably one of the way huge glides. You know, probably Superbus or something. Yeah. You know, just learn everything, be cool, be nice to people. Yeah, that's what I learned early, is just, you know, back in pre-internet days, you know, you had to be really nice to people to get information. It wasn't like, you know, guaranteed someone would tell you anything. Man, that's a tough one. I mean, to me, the most iconic is Fuzzface. I love Fuzzfaces. I love the fact that I get to work on them and make them. My favorite to work with has been Bonamassa. It's a delight. He's a great dude. It's a lot of fun to work with. It's
amazing collection of guitars.
Yeah, you go up to the house and play all the guitars. It's great, but it's a really relaxed environment to work with. It's really, we hang out, talk about stuff, cool, tinker away, come back, try this. You know, it's great. I probably have. I can't think of it. It's usually more, you know, the opposite, where I'm like, oh wow, I would have never thought to use it that way.
Yeah.
You know, there's a number of people that I follow, even on Instagram, like, oh wow, that's super cool. Never thought to plug, you know, this into that and do that. I mean, the green tea is always good. There's a handful of different green teas, but the Hokkaido melon is one of my favorite. One I think I like least was there's like a like a purple yam, I think. It's just, it was strange. It wasn't horrible. Some of the really cool ones, there was one I had, it was like a creme brulee you put in the toaster. So you had to do it right, otherwise it would just totally melt.